Now we are going to start disaccharides. We know that disaccharides on hydrolysis gives a number of monosaccharides units. So here we have two monosaccharides units. When combined together, they give rise to disaccharides. These disaccharides comes under the category of oligosaccharides. So the monomers, monosaccharides which act as a monomer unit are linked by your glycosidic linkage. There is an oxygen linkage between the monosaccharides unit, and these are known as glycosidic linkage. So I have written here the oxide linkage between the two monosaccharides unit is called glycosidic linkage. In this disaccharides, the first category we are having is our sucrose. Sucrose has the molecular formula of C12H22O11, and when it is hydrolyzed, it gives me glucose and fructose. Again, I have told you that glucose and fructose are having the same molecular formula, but one is your aldose sugar and the second one is your ketose sugar. So I have made the pyranose structure of glucose here, and this fructose, furanose structure of fructose is there. So there is a linkage between the C1 carbon of glucose and C2 carbon of fructose. So this is your C1 carbon of glucose and this is the C2 carbon of your fructose. They combines together and water molecule is eliminated, giving a linkage between carbon 1 and carbon 2 with oxygen. This oxide linkage between the two monosaccharides unit are known as glycosidic linkage, and this is how the sucrose is formed. So sucrose is the molecule which can consist of monosaccharides unit of glucose and fructose. So when these glucose and fructose are linked together by the loss of water molecule and the linkage are through the glycosidic linkage is known as your sucrose. The another example of your disaccharide is maltose. Before going to maltose, we will go for the invert sugar. What is invert sugar? We know that sucrose is dextrorotatory, and when we keep it in, hydrolyze it in water, we get equimolar mixture of glucose and fructose. Earlier you have seen in slide first. So this equimolar mixture of glucose and fructose is levorotatory. So a dextrorotatory compound means the rotation is your clockwise, has turned to rotation to your anti-clockwise. This is an inversion of the sign of optical rotation from dextro to levo, and the equimolar mixture of glucose and fructose thus obtained is known as invert sugar. So invert sugar is not only a single sugar, it is an equimolar mixture of glucose and fructose. Now moving to the maltose, maltose again have the molecular formula as C12H22O11, but it is different from sucrose because on hydrolysis we get two molecules of glucose only. So this is this is your pyranose structure of glucose, and here the linkage take place from carbon 1 to carbon 4 of the another glucose unit. Water is eliminated. Both the units are joined by the oxygen linkage, which is known as your glycosidic linkage. One thing very important over here, that you have to place OH group at the lower position in glucose. Otherwise, if you keep the OH position upward, it will become galactose. So in maltose, the linkage is from C1 to C4. Of the another glucose unit. In this way the maltose is formed. The next one is your lactose. Lactose on hydrolysis give beta D glucose and beta D galactose. Now this is the structure of beta D galactose. In this structure, that's very similar to that of the glucose, but the only difference is that at carbon 4, if OH is at the upper side, then it will become galactose, and if OH is in the lower side, then it will become your glucose. Always remember, student, the position of OH at carbon 4 for your galactose and glucose. Now here the linkage take place between carbon 1 of galactose unit and carbon carbon 4 of glucose unit. So it is your beta galactose. So OH at carbon 1 position will be at upward direction. And similarly, we have beta D glucose. So carbon 1 has OH upside. So there is the linkage between your carbon 1 and carbon 4, and we know that in glucose OH group is lying downward at carbon 4. So a cross linkage is formed like this. A cross linkage glycosidic linkage is formed in galactose. So in maltose we are having a straight glycosidic linkage, linear glycosidic linkage, whereas in lactose we are having a cross glycosidic linkage. The two galactose and glucose unit are joined at carbon 1 of galactose and carbon 1,4 of glucose unit. So again I am repeating that in glucose carbon 4 OH is downward, and in galactose carbon 4 OH fourth position per carbon pay OH position is upward. Now we are starting our polysaccharides. As we know that polysaccharides on hydrolysis will give a large number of your monosaccharides unit. Under this category we are having starch and cellulose. So we are starting with the starch first. This starch is a major source of carbohydrate, which are very much important to the human body since they supply energy to the body, and they occurs mainly in seeds, fruits, tubers and also in the roots of the plant. And the commercial sources of this starch is your wheat, maize, rice, potatoes, etc. So this starch consists of two components. One is your amylose and the second one is your amylopectin. So amylose is your linear structure, whereas your amylopectin is your branch structure. The amylose is water soluble, whereas amylopectin is water insoluble. We came to know that starch is a polysaccharide, so it is a very large molecule. It is not, we will not able to understand it if we are going as a whole structure of the starch. So we have to understand the two components of starch. First one is your amylose. So amylose on hydrolysis give rise to maltose and glucose. These are your alpha D glucose, and we know that maltose is a disaccharide, already has covered in your disaccharide topic. So this maltose is again on hydrolysis give rise to alpha D glucose and alpha D glucose, two units of glucose. So basically amylose is made up of three units of alpha D glucose, two from maltose and one acid. So there is a linkage between the three molecules of glucose, and this linkage take place from C1 of one glucose unit to C4 of another glucose unit. See here, this is the oxygen linkage between the two monosaccharides unit of glucose, which is known as glycosidic linkage, and a linear chain structure is formed. This has been joined with another glucose unit, maltose units, and then to the glucose unit. So this is a linear chain structure, and because of this linear chain structure they are water soluble. However, this amylopectin consists of the amylose chain. Okay, and there are two type of linkage takes place in amylopectin. One is your linear linkage. This is one is your linear linkage, which takes place between C1 and C4. See here, this one is also your linear linkage, which has taken place between C1 and C4 of the two monosaccharides linkage. Then there is a branch linkage also. This one is your branch linkage, which has been taken place between the C1 of the terminal glucose molecule of one amylose chain and C6 of the another unit of the another terminal glucose molecule of the another chain. So there is a branch linkage between C1 and C2 of the two linear molecules of amylose of the terminal glucose. So two type of linkage has been formed in amylopectin. One is your linear linkage and the second one is your branch linkage. And due to this branch linkage, amylopectin is your branch structure, and this makes it water insoluble. And these two structure combines together, that is amylose and amylopectin structure combines together to give me the structure of starch, which is not possible to right here. Now the second one is our cellulose. Cellulose on hydrolysis give rise to beta D glucose. So student, remember that we are having a alpha D glucose unit. Maltose is also having alpha D glucose, and glucose is also here alpha D glucose. So basically the difference between starch and cellulose is that starch consists of alpha D glucose, whereas cellulose consists of beta D glucose. So there is a beta linkage take place in cellulose at C1 and C4 of the glucose units. So C1 mein hamara beta mein OH will be upside, and C4 mein OH will be downside. Always in glucose at C4 position, the OH is at the lower end. So there will be linkage between end linkage, or this linkage is known as beta linkage between the glucose unit, beta D glucose unit, and therefore they combine together to give a large molecule known as cellulose.